I'm gonna fight the global war on terror. When I get a chance to stamp out evil in this world, I love that. Sorry, I love hunting down bad guys and ending them.
Driving down into a city, there's this weird mix of excitement, fear, and also an odd serenity. We wanted to make a statement, hence the choice to use a detonator and a bomb.
As soon as the vehicle stops, the doors open, and it's showtime.
Isaac Gilmore is a former Navy SEAL who later became second in command of a private U.S. military firm called Speer Operations Group. This is the first time anyone from Speer has spoken on camera.
One of the reasons that I agreed to be part of this documentary is to be very clear about what we're doing and why. This isn't, you know, innocent until proven guilty. It's war. And so you have intelligence, and then you act on it.
In 2015, Yemen was gripped by fighting on several fronts. A rebel group called the Houthis had taken over the capital, Sana'a. Al-Qaeda had long been a presence in the south and were now gaining territory. The US feared they might plan terrorist operations beyond Yemen's borders. The UAE took over security for southern Yemen and became the US's main counterterrorism ally in the region. It hired Speer Group to conduct counterterrorism operations in Yemen. Dale Comstock spent decades in the US Special Forces before becoming a mercenary with Speer.
Did you enjoy your time in Yemen?
Honestly, no. But we weren't there to go to Club Med, you know? We had a job to do, and that's just what soldiers do. You suck it up.
Who gave you the targets?
We received the target intelligence from the UAE government.
فاتضح انه في نفس اللحظه نزل بيان في احد المواقع انه تم اغتيال انصاب مائي بحادث تفجير سياره. في هذا الاثناء انا عرفت ان انا كنت المساعد. لاي شيء لاي ذنب يعني.
On Ansaf Mayo in particular, what was it that made you decide that he is a terrorist?
Well, there's a couple things. One, we already know that he was being financed by the Muslim Brotherhood.
The United States government doesn't believe the Muslim Brotherhood is a terrorist organization.
Oh, yeah, they did. At one point, they did. If my handlers say, here's the intelligence, this is the target, and this is why, who am I to question? I'm a soldier for you. Roger that.
And your handlers are the UAE?
Yeah, they're the client. Yeah, they're the client.
The policies of Ansaf's party, Al-Islah, are inspired by the Muslim Brotherhood, a popular international Islamist movement. The Muslim Brotherhood is banned in several countries, including the UAE, where their political activism and support for elections is seen as a threat to the rule of the royal family. But the US has never classified the Muslim Brotherhood as a terrorist organization.
What was the intel that you were provided with about Ansaf Mayo that made you think he was connected to terrorist organizations?
I cannot go into the details of the intel.
But he isn't a terrorist, is he, Isaac? I mean, I've met him since. He has taken part in the UN peace process.
Which is fantastic.
For Yemen.
The very nature of intelligence gathering is that it's never 100% absolute. War is always messy. But anytime there's conflict, there's going to be people that are hurt or killed that you wish weren't.